Brian, I'd like to try something.
Okay, great.
I just want you to relax.
Okay. That's a little distracting.
No, it's part of the therapy, you'll see. Now, tell me about the first time you met Allison.
Okay, well, I was ordering a turkey sandwich at this great little bistro when Allison... What was that for?
It's slap therapy. It's from China. It unblocks your obstructed meridians. So please continue.
Okay. Well, anyway, that's when Allison... But you told me to talk about Allison.
Go on.
Well, I don't want to talk about her anymore.
See, Ryan, we're making progress.
We are? Wow, I gotta say, you are the best therapist I have ever had.
Thank you. Well, our time's up.
Oh. Okay. I guess I'll see you on Tuesday.
Yes.
Okay, and I will not be mentioning Allison. I thought you said our time was up.
No charge.
Jeez, don't you have a home?
I could say the same thing about you guys.
Whoa, Kim, no need to be hostile.
Hey, what's wrong? You look awful.
Oh, it's nothing. Just have this raging stress migraine.
He just found out he's getting a big award.
Please, stop yelling.
Why would getting an award give you a migraine?
It all started back in middle school. I won this huge award, and the principal goes to give it to me, and you know, I don't want to talk about it. It was bad, okay? It was awful. It was traumatizing.
Were you touched?
What? No!
Jeez, Kim, you go dark fast.
Some kid pantsed him in front of the whole school.
Everyone was laughing at me.
Oh, it's not that big a deal.
Seriously, minor embarrassment. I've had worse traumas today.
Why'd you just skip the ceremony?
I can't. It's for some pro bono work I did for Big Brothers. They're holding this huge ceremony at the courthouse just for me. God, why do I have to be such an amazing person?
You know, my therapist deals with anxiety issues all the time. Maybe you could talk to her.
I don't know. I mean, nothing against therapy, but you've been doing it for 30 years and, well, you know.
Trust me, okay? She's a little unorthodox, but amazing.
You know, you guys should think about getting laid. That's what I'm about to do. Best therapy out there.
Are you still dating Jenny What's-Her-Face?
No, it's Laura something or other. She's the chick from Big Brothers who dropped off the tickets for Danny's award banquet.
She was here for 4 seconds.
I know. I'm getting old. It's embarrassing.
So, you just met her, and you're already planning to hop into bed with her?
I feel like you're trying to make a point, but I don't know what it is.
My point is you're a pig. You don't even know anything about her.
Well, I know she had boobs. Great big round boobs, like giant owl eyes staring through the night.
Boobs make you so poetic.
You should hear my ass haiku. Come on, give me a ride home, Ryan.
Feel better, Danny.
God, I'm so stressed out. What am I gonna do?
You know, I hate to even say this, but Sheldon might have had a good idea how to relieve your stress.
How is Sheldon having sex gonna relieve my stress? Oh.
Danny, it's okay. This happens to every guy. It's just the anxiety.
I'm going to see Ryan's therapist.
Okay, I think you're overreacting.
Where are you going?
To take one of my showers.
But you just took a Oh!
Here, try this.
King pole tea. Is that good for my nerves?
It's good for your limp noodle.
You told her about that?
It may have slipped out in conversation.
But how does something like that slip out?
We were talking about it.
It's nothing, really.
Guys, I'm in trouble. I think Laura slipped me something last night. After our date, I've been feeling kind of funny.
Funny how?
I don't know. It's weird. I mean, I slept with her, and for some reason, I'm still thinking about her. And I'm thinking about her now, and now, and now.
How about now?
Actually, yes. I can still smell her perfume. Oh, no, maybe it's a brain tumor.
Yeah, you need a brain for that.
If you weren't Sheldon, I'd say you actually care for this woman.
Don't be ridiculous. I mean, sure, I haven't checked out another broad all day, and every time I think about her, I get this dopey look on my face. Oh, no.
I had that exact same look when I met Kim.
That's not funny, Danny.
You know, I can't believe I'm saying this, but maybe you're finally ready for a mature relationship.
She's not old, Kim.
I know that's not what I meant.
I know what you meant. I was deliberately making a joke to hide... to hide my true feelings. Oh, no. It's worse than I thought.
Sheldon, maybe you want to tell this girl how you feel.
Oh. Yeah, you're right. Maybe I should. How's this sound? Laura, I have feelings for you. And not just below the waist.
That would work for me. Hello works for you.
Hey, thanks for letting me take part of your session.
No problem. I can't wait for you to meet Sydney. Oh, and because this is your first therapy session, I made you a starter kit. Tissues. Dream journal. More tissues. Hand sanitizer. You never know what kind of weirdos were in here before you.
Thanks, Ryan.
Hello. Hi. Hi. I'm Dr. Sydney Forbes. You must be Ryan's brother.
Thanks for seeing me.
Danny has been having some anxiety issues because he's getting this award from Big Brothers.
Handsome and a big heart. Impressive. Here, have a seat.
Great.
Maybe you're right. Maybe he is too good for his girlfriend. Okay, now I want to try something. Just relax.
Hello.
Now tell me the first time you experienced this anxiety.
Don't mention Allison. Well, I was in middle school, and I just won this huge award.
Here we go.
Chinese reflexology. How does that feel?
Unfair?
Amazing, actually. Wow.
You know, I find when I'm nervous about public speaking, I like to picture people in their underwear.
Right. No, I heard about that.
So why don't we practice with me? Can you picture me in my panties? You are so cute. Don't you just want to smother him?
Yes.
You know, I don't like to throw the word hero around, but to be raised by your brothers and turn out so great. Wow.
Okay. Well, thanks for seeing Danny. He's all better now. We should probably get going. He's so busy being a hero and all.
Actually, Ryan, I'd like to spend some time with Danny alone.
Sure. That's understandable. It's not personal at all. So I'll just get the heck out of here. Don't want to intrude. Okay. Wow. I am so glad this worked out so well!
I'm telling you, Ryan's therapist was great. Her techniques have already made me feel so much better. She even said it would help in the bedroom.
You mean his birth control?
Hey, there he is.
Hey.
So how'd it go with Laura? Did you tell her how you feel?
I did.
That's wonderful. Good for you. What did she say?
She dumped me.
Oh, no. Well, how you feeling?
Well, I'm okay, I guess. Except for this eye allergy, it keeps leaking.
So you took her to dinner theater, everything's going great.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, she says, this isn't working out. And she leaves.
Look, Sheldon, it's simple. Was she having a bad day?
You mean, was she riding the Crimson Tide? Well, that's just another way of saying...
I get it. Sheldon, I mean, did she say anything about her feelings?
Probably, but you know, that's the kind of thing I tend to tune out.
But So you were ignoring her?
Oh, come on, look, I'm not Superman, Kim. I can't listen and pay attention at the same time. Plus, this was dinner theater. You're supposed to be paying attention to the horses.
Horses? What kind of dinner theater has horses?
Medieval times?
I mean, the place where you eat with your hands?
Look, if you know of a better way to eat 4 pounds of turkey teat, I'd like to know about it.
I bet you slapped your waitress on the butt, too.
First of all, they're called wenches, and second, it would be rude not to.
So, to sum it up, you showed no interest in Laura's feelings, didn't listen to a word she said, and fondled another woman right in front of her.
I'm not even a woman, and I'm offended.
Look, it's nothing I haven't done to a million girls before, okay? Look, women are crazy.
Did you ever think that it might be you?
Go on.
Some women appreciate things like manners and attentiveness, not slapping wenches on the ass.
Well, that's a hell of a thing to keep to yourself, Kim. You know, doesn't matter now. It's too late. I'm never gonna see her again.
Well, actually, since she volunteers for Big Brothers, we're all gonna see her again at the banquet.
Hey, wait a minute. You're right. I might have a chance to win her back. Do you think you can teach me all that women crap before the weekend?
You know, I housebroke a dog once. I could give it a try.
Thanks. You know, I take back a third of all the horrible things I've ever said about you.
Okay, good. Next time, try holding the door open for your date.
Right, okay, good. You don't have a piece of paper, do you? I should probably be writing this stuff down.
Now, if you brought me here on our date, what would you do first?
Well, first of all, I'd probably apologize for taking you somewhere so annoying. And then I'd take you to a bar so we could get loaded.
Well, thank you, Sheldon, but I like it here. Would you go get me a cup of chai?
What, your leg's not working?
You got a lot of work to do.
And the doctor even gave me a lollipop. Now, let's see if you were listening. In the story, did I receive for my birthday A, a bike, B, a cow, or C, nothing?
I don't know. All of the above? I mean, come on. This stuff is hard. I'm trying to listen, but you're really, really boring.
Okay, let's try this. What color bra is the woman in the back corner wearing?
Key lime green, push up, Victoria's Secret catalog, page 17.
Right. But wrong. You're supposed to be listening to your date. If you find yourself leering, just use the elastic.
Ow!
Now, next question. Nikki, begin the test. Oh. In the story of my favorite doll, was her dress...
Ow!
You have to be attentive. Eyes and ears on your date at all times.
So just to be clear, not my hands.
Oh, we've been over this. Accidental boob gropes are never, ever appropriate.
I can't help it. It's not my fault. Women just love to put their boobs into my hand.
You're impossible. Okay, let's try working on how you look when you're being attentive.
Okay, no problem.
You're never gonna guess what happened yesterday when I was at the mall. I met my best friend Joanne, and she was wearing this great dress. We went to our favorite store, and then she bought me these earrings.
I can't do it.
Well, yeah, let's just take a break.
I just... See?
Danny, where have you been? I've been calling you all day. What happened with Dr. Forbes?
Hello, Ryan.
You're here with Danny making a house call with Chardonnay.
Sid is here interviewing me for a book she's writing.
It's all about exceptional people who have overcome childhood adversity.
You're an exceptional person, which makes me the adversity. Can I talk to you for a second?
Look, Ryan, I was gonna tell you about it, but I didn't want you to go and get all... you.
Well, I wouldn't worry about me, buddy, because as soon as Kim finds out about you and Sid, I think it's gonna result in some major fireworks.
Going. Hi.
My therapist is friends with everyone now.
Oh, Ryan. My socializing with your brother and your brother's girlfriend has nothing to do with us. You're one of my favorite clients, and you know that.
Well, thank you. It's very nice.
And my interest in Danny is as a subject. He's very unique, brilliant mind, and he's gone through so much. Kind of like Oprah.
Okay.
Kim, I gotta tell you, this has been a grueling, sweet, freshly baked cinnamon bear claws.
You must be Sheldon. Sidney Forbes.
Bless the beasts and the children.
Sheldon? Sheldon, why don't you try having a conversation with Sidney? I think it might be a good exercise.
Yeah, why don't you, Sheldon? In fact, everyone should talk to her. It's only my greatest nightmare, and I have no one to talk to about it.
Okay, sounds like a good idea. Hello, how are you today? Are you two enjoying this wonderful weather?
Okay.
I know, I went too far.
You don't worry about it. It was a unfair test.
Practice makes perfect. I'm going back in.
Wow, Sheldon. You look great.
Thank you, Kim. Your kind words mean a lot to me.
So, are you ready to win Laura back?
Are you kidding? I haven't worked so hard for anything in my whole life.
Well, back to business. What was my best friend's name when I was 14?
Well, you thought it was Christine, but given how she backstabbed you at the winter formal, Monica turned out to be your best friend all along.
Way to go.
Right, guys, let's go. Wow. You look so hot tonight.
Danny, please. She's not a wench.
Oh, look, you guys all came together. I'm surprised your new best friend, Dr. Forbes, didn't come with you.
That would be ridiculous. She couldn't make it.
Oh, if you'll excuse me, I do believe I see my lady friend.
Remember, you can do this. Just remember. Sensitivity, listening, understanding, and trust.
S-L-U-T. Slut. Evening, Laura.
Wow, Sheldon, you look completely different.
Well, I've been thinking about you. And I know I wasn't the greatest date. I know I didn't listen to you. I took you to a restaurant with horses and poop. And I was even staring at other women. But I've changed. I promise to treat you right and try to be a better man, no matter how much it hurts.
Sheldon, that's beautiful. Buy me a drink?
Yeah.
You know, I'm just gonna get a drink.
Okay. I can't hold this in any longer. I don't like that you're friends with my therapist.
You know, I suspected there was a small chance you might overreact.
Oh, and yet here I am, perfectly calm.
You know, Ryan, I had one problem that I needed help with, and somehow you've made it all about you.
Are you kidding me? Did you just say that to my face right now? Look at this place, man! It's a Danny Fest! Danapalooza! It's Dana-frickin'-rama! I'm drinking a Dantini!
I'm the guest of honor!
Yeah, well, I would like to be the guest of honor in my own therapist's office.
Can we please talk about this later? You're making my anxiety flare up. Stop it!
Damn it!
So, enjoying the event?
Oh, it's wonderful. But to be honest, I'd be more comfortable if there weren't so many coloreds here. I'm going to the ladies' room. Make sure one of them doesn't steal my purse.
Mom liked me best until you were born, all helpless and useless.
So you wish I was never born?
How do you think I dropped you on your head when you were two?
I can never shave my head!
So, how's it going with Laura?
Great. I've been asking a lot of questions, and it turns out she's a real...
human being with emotional depth.
Racist.
What? Racist? You stopped listening again, didn't you?
Oh, no. I've been listening, and I hear racist.
But all I'm hearing is you just can't listen to women.
Hi. Hi, sweetie.
Oh, can you get that wetback over there to take my drink?
I'm pretty sure he's a Supreme Court justice.
Good evening. I'd like to introduce tonight's honoree, winner of the Price Stolberg Humanitarian Award, the exceptional Danny White.
Later.
Must be Jews.
Danny, I'm sorry. I don't know what came over me. I guess I was just jealous.
What, of me?
Sydney was right. You do have it all. Big-ass career, loving girlfriend, awards coming out, the friggin' yin-yang. I want to pants you again. Look, therapy is the one thing I do really, really well.
Well, Sydney did mention that you are a very unique patient.
You're damn right I am, and she's lucky to have me. Look, if you want to keep seeing her, it's fine. Especially after tonight.
No, no need. I was pantsed in front of a room full of people, and it wasn't that big a deal.
It was pretty funny, though. Justice Gonzalez laughed so hard, he spit his Dantini through his nose.
Maybe I'll call Dr. Forbes after all.
There you go.
No.